بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، أما بعد. اللهم ربنا تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا ودعاءنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم ربنا اجعلنا من عتقائك من النيران في هذا الشهر الكريم. والله You love to pardon, pardon us, O Allah, free us from the doom of the hellfire in this blessed month, Ya Allah. The Siyam has the effect and the impact to increase the piety. And now, Alhamdulillah, we have a week. Yeah? So, check your measure of piety. If you have one, inshallah. Inshallah, all of you have one. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. However, one of the measure of the piety is to be watching yourself. Watching yourself. And this is not part of the khatira. Watch yourself because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you outside the masjid. So when you are inside the masjid, mashallah, you're standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're trying to get your khushu' and you're standing in full humility. But outside the masjid is also required piety. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتُ Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. Now, I'm just making this, you know, to help ourselves understand that the piety is not in the masjid. The piety starts with every part of your life, with every aspect of your life. Starting, if you leave the masjid, the parking is very important. You have your brother who's working, they are, subhanAllah, you know, the soldiers, inshaAllah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who working and acting. If you do not respect those brother, we don't have piety. If we drive in a crazy way, thinking just to get to the first row, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know that you passed your brother. And then if you take his place, Allah is going to cancel that place from your record because you have transgressed your brother by passing him in a way almost you have got an accident. And this is what I have been witnessing when I was coming to the masjid. Let's be pious. Outside the masjid, inside the masjid, when you are behind the wheels, you know, especially when someone seeing us drive and look, and he see the face like us, brown, and especially with the big hat, like say, Muslim. Say, but if you stop and you say, okay, oh, Muslim, you know. So that appreciation, it helps us to make the da'wah. It helps us to make the da'wah. I don't know how I'm going to get to the khatira. طيب. When you are invited to meet a person, you know. One of the things, there's two aspects. You want to listen, is an elder person, someone you respect, someone you are longing to see. You want to listen to them, but also you want to see them. Musa alayhi salam, when he was invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked to him, then the shawq of the Musa, the longing of the Musa, when he heard Allah speaking to him, Allah speaking to Musa alayhi salam. This is the greatest honor for the whole humankind, for Allah to pick one of them to speak to him directly, who is Musa alayhi salam. قال ولما كلمه ربه, when his Lord talked to him, قال ربي أرني أنظر إليك. Oh, my Lord, let me see you. Yeah? It's amazing. The natural way, as I have made in the introduction, if you're going to meet someone, you want to see them. So that elevate oneself to the level of seeing the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is something of the most amazing thing that someone can experience, especially when Musa, he already listening to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ Let me see you, Ya Allah. Allah's rahmah upon Musa alayhi salam, He said, you cannot. Which is mean your structure, the way you're being created on this earth, you cannot handle it. You cannot. قال لن ترى. Cannot. قال ولكن انظر الجبل. Look at the mountain. Now, some of the narration, as is mentioned in many of the books, and especially in the book of the Tawabin of Imam al-Maqdisi, because he put one of the Tawbah of Musa alayhi salam is this Tawbah. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will to send a part of His light, yeah, something that we cannot even comprehend and imagine, but is a light like, you know, that's, you know, the eye of a needle, or less, or the infinite part of the eye of the needle. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going to manifest Himself, His light subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the mountain, to just look at the mountain, the amount of angel they came down making tasbih and shaken from the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody can even imagine that. So Musa alayhi salam, already by seeing all the scenery, all this was going on around him, he realized that he asked something so big, something so big. Then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His light on the mountain, قَالَ فَلَمَّ تَجَلَّ رَبَّ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looked at the mountain the way He will subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole mountain, imagine the whole mountain turn into dust. Turn into dust. Musa could not handle such a thing. Just he lost conscience. The last thing he saw is such something is unspeakable. So when he woke up, قال سبحانك, be exalted. سبحانك is a tawbah, ya Allah, that I even ask you, I dare to ask you such a thing. تُبْتُ إِلَيْكَ I repent to you, ya Allah. And I am the first of the believers. One of the things that we would like to inspire from this great event, a historical event, an event that you will stay in eternity, recited in the book of Allah, and reminded in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, rahmah, rahmah. Because all the believers, insha'Allah, you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because everybody, insha'Allah ta'ala, Allah will admit us in His rahmah to be recreated, so we'll be able to just stand or be able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. However, if you don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today with your heart, you might not be able to see Allah tomorrow in the hereafter. So, what are the elements if we want to dig into our behavior in what we need to really work on to see Allah with our heart, which is actually the ihsan. That's the ihsan when Jibreel alayhi salam asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about ihsan, قال, أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى. To worship Allah as you see Him. So there is a way to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your heart. So the first element, dear brother, respected sister, is to take the example or how the mountain turned into dust. This one of the attributes, the sifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you imagine how powerful Allah's, you know, power, how powerful and you measure, you know, the rahmah of Allah is bigger in size and in power than when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at the mountain. Allah is helping to you is bigger than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supporting you is bigger than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala watching you, watching over you is bigger than that. Then when you immerse yourself and get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to study His attribute, just think about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close to you, how you want Allah to help you, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you want to provide you, and remember that power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us, you know, with an infinite part of His light and what it did to His mountain, to this mountain. Therefore, it just to liberate yourself, because you are with Allah the powerful, with just an infinite light of His subhanahu wa ta'ala, turn the mountain is dust. You are with Allah. If we think in that way, it truly, you're going to help yourself, free yourself from this worldly life, from subhanAllah, the fear, which is like comes to two elements. If you want, inshaAllah, to help ourselves, get to the level that we have Allah to be with you. Allah is with you, but are you with Allah? So when we say Allah to be with us, we have first to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you think about the example on this ayat in Surah Al-A'raf, he said the first thing that we need to ask for first is for Allah to ease our heart for His dhikr, to expand our heart. Look, Musa alayhi salam, what he said, قَالَ رَبِّ شْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي. Ask Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted that to His Prophet, قَالَ أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to really put peace into your heart, to expand your breast, to feel good, to breathe, despite the difficulty that you are surrounding you, despite the hardship that is striking you, you're going to feel good. Why? Because with you, Allah, who has the power that He mentioned, the just example for you to just be a measure for you. And when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to expand your chest, to put peace into your heart, to peace, an inner joy into your soul. For one reason, what is the reason? Musa alayhi salam, the long dua that he made, قَالَ كَيْنُ سَبِّحَكَ كَثِيرًا وَنَذْكُرَكَ كَثِيرًا, to celebrate your praises, Ya Allah, and to remember you much. That's the first element. Then ask Allah to make sharh of your sadr, of your breast, so you'll be able to be more from those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The objective. Because when you come to that point, believe me, all the sorrow, all the grief, all the anxiety and the problem that you have is going to be subhanAllah. You will not find a place there. You're going to have a garden in your chest. Wherever you go, you feel good because you are with Allah, the one who has the power, the one who is infinite light, turned the mountain into dust. The second one is to fight the fear. Fight the fear. SubhanAllah, the fear of not getting enough provision, of the fear of the unknown future. Are we going to keep the same job? Are you going to have the income? Are we going to do this? Are you going to have the children getting, finish their studies, their school? Are we going? SubhanAllah, we are surrounding ourselves with a lot of worries, scaring ourselves when Allah is with you. Musa alayhi salam, when he went to meet with his brother Harun, to meet Fir'aun, it was something so scary. It's a tyrant that he was in his hand by one sign, and Musa and Harun, they will be killed right there. قَالَ إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ, we fear Ya Allah, we fear Ya Allah, that he go overboard, this person. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَ, do not fear, I am with you. I hear and I see. So dear brother, respected sister, Allah is with you, seeing, hearing, and with you in every aspect of your life. If you inquire your help, His help, you need only you to be with Allah. So the fear that the shaitan is scaring us in all this surrounding that we have in all our life is really to take that fervor, that eagerness in our heart to be remembering Allah. That's what the shaitan, قال الشيطان ليحزن الذين, he wants you to cause you grief into your heart. إنما ذلكم الشيطان يخوف أولياءه فلا تخافوهم. The fear is the prison, subhanAllah, of the soul. The fear make you suffocate. The fear make you weak. The fear make you kneel. And you ask yourself, why should I fear? when Allah is with you. And remember the power of Allah in the example of Musa alayhi salam. Sharh and fight the fear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you'll find yourself in an amazing place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with His husna for you. His grant, He granted you. He said, O you who believe, remember Allah, a match of remembrance in the morning and the evening. Yeah? Then he said, it's Him who's sending Him, He's sending a blessing upon you. And He ordaining His angels to ask forgiveness for you. Because He is the most merciful to you. هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّ عَلَيْكُمْ. Look how great. Can you imagine you are in your bed and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specially sending blessing to you? You are in your bed and the carrier of the throne making dua for you. Look how honored you are. And people still begging other people to help him do things. Ya akhi, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Turn to the most powerful. قال, and then after that, if you do such a thing, قال, look what he directed you. تحيتهم يوم يلقون. Their greeting to him when they meet him is salam. So you see, the path to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was not granted to Musa to see Allah in this life, because it's impossible for the human being today to see Allah. But in the day of judgment, you will. Therefore, let's make one of the objectives of Ramadan to see Allah with your heart. So inshallah, you will be able, bi-idhnillah, to be admitted from the list of the people of the Jannah who are going to be seeing Allah in the day of Al-Mazid. Say Ameen wa ila salati arhamkum.